How to build a website using Weebly. Hi, Local Search Canada, Freddie Fulton here. And we're going to walk through building a basic site using Weebly. And this is the free option on Weebly. And we'll begin right away. And go to weebly.com, enter that URL, and then you'll come to this page where you can just create your user account. I am going to do that. We're going to go start to finish on this. And it's only about 11 minutes long to get the site live on the internet with a Weebly hosted account. So the first thing you need to do is choose a theme, and there's plenty of good free themes, not used themes. And we're going to choose this, I like this black one with the rustic background. I've used it before. And so we're going to enter a Weebly.com domain, and this is a subdomain, it's free, and it allows you to put up a three-page website, so pretty basic, but so we're going to choose that option. But if you have your own domain, you can direct it here, or you can register a new domain right on Weebly. So we're going to call this XYZ Golf. I'm going to actually put a little golf website together for a golf professional who's asking me to put a small site together for him. So we're just going to walk through that right now. So here's the tutorial. We're going to skip that, but definitely worth watching if it's your first time. So we're going to begin. Basically, it starts with the home page being built with the theme that you picked. So I'm going to put in a title, then we're going to edit this image, because this road really doesn't have anything to do with golf. So I've downloaded some images from a free stock photo site, and we're going to use this one on our homepage. It's a nice clear graphic that I really like for this golf website. So we're going to add this, and then we're going to have to normally center it and line it up, but it just came in perfect, oddly enough, and I'm going to leave that as is. I don't even have to test the width or anything, so we're going to save that. And then you also have the option of saving it to this page and every other page. So if you save it to all pages, it will then be on all pages. So we're going to save it just to this one because it is a big graphic. I like it on the first page, but I do not think I want that on every page. So now we're just going to build this small site, kind of the framework, and we're going to add a couple more pages besides the home page. So the contact page, this is how prospective customers will be able to get a hold of the golf professional in this case, or your business. And so we added that page. We didn't add a picture, but we're going to go now and add one more page, which will be the golf bio page. So in this case, it's an about page basically, and we'll talk about the golf professional's qualifications, but this would be your business qualifications or your about page, the address and whatnot. And we're going to have a little picture on that page. So basically this website is framed. We got the home, we got the contact page, we got the golf bio. So now we're going to add the picture now to the home page. Actually, no, this is the bio page. So this is the header, and this is how you set the pictures, and you can really bring in almost any size of picture and just edit it and drag it and fit it in just like we did there, which is nice. So we're going to OK that. We're going to save it just to this page because we don't want to reset the home page. And so we'll look at the home page, and that'll have the larger graphic still, so that's good. Now we're going to add some content here. Many options. You can put in title, text, just an image, image and text, a slideshow, which is nice. We're going to add, first some columns. And so we added a two-column layout here. We have many options. We could have done the image and text, but we're going to add the image on the left of this two-column layout, and we'll put the text on the right side. So basically that sets up the layout, and we're going to first add the we're adding the text, which I actually did already, but I realize it actually added down below, which you will see later. So now we're going to add the text, which I want you to have to watch me type it out. So bringing it in from a Word doc, and so this is just going to be the home page, welcome message, who we're talking about, services we provide, and pretty basic information. We're going to next add the picture on the left. So the formatting, you use the I guess we'll call it a text editor up top here to increase the size of the fonts, bold, underline, all of that kind of stuff, and adding links and centering and list building, all of that stuff is using that text editor. You don't have to learn HTML or any sort of programming with this, so it makes building a website very easy. Weebly does. Now we're going to add a picture here on our homepage just to make it look nice and glossy, and I'm going to choose this golfer, and this will load up, and that size looks pretty good. And you can see down below that text box that I lost earlier, it's actually down below. You just have to click on the right side and delete it, and off it goes. So that's our homepage, it's done. Next we're going to add the contact page, which is going to just be a form. I'll drag that over. You just drag it from the right, or from the left to the right, and this is the form. And again, you can make this a lot prettier, but we'll just add the title, and you can also change the form layout as well. It doesn't have to be name and message and email. You can pretty much add whatever you want. And then here's the thank you message, which you can edit as well. And you can have that as just a message that pops up, or a link to another page if you want. And that just automatically saves when you click save. So your contact page is done in a matter of seconds. No building forms or coding required, so that's nice. And now we're going to add our final page, which is the golf bio page. And again, here I'm just going to add image and text together on this page just to show you the difference. And it will actually wrap the text around the image, which is a nice feature, especially if you're doing a lot of posts and you want to incorporate images. It just makes the appearance that much cleaner and professional looking. So we're gonna again cut and paste in all this information so we don't have to watch me type it, because I tried to keep this as much as real time as possible. I may have cut 30 seconds out of this just for loading of a couple of the images, but that is about it. So we're going to do some basic editing here, and again, when I get this finalized, I'm going to make it look much better. You can spend a lot of time on the editing. You can actually go into the themes, change the settings on the entire site if you want a different font, you want a different color for headings versus the text. It's all customizable. And so we're going to save that. Well, we're not going to save. We're going to fix this heading, and then we're going to save that. And that page is pretty much. So it's ready to go. We got social icons, which is, you know, really important these days. This is where you'd put your Facebook page, your Twitter profile if you have one, LinkedIn, and email. And these buttons will just pop up a window if someone clicks on them to. In this case, it'll send an email to my website address. And I'm going to leave the Facebook, Twitter, and whatnot empty right now, but I mean, that is a really nice feature that used to be quite difficult to do. And we're going to publish this. And I'm going to skip this step. And I just skipped over the verification that I'm a human part, so you don't have to watch that. And here is the live site. So this is what it looks like on the internet. There's my button at the top left for my email, home, contact, bio. This is the home page. Considering it's been 10 minutes, it looks pretty slick. And here's the contact page. I would probably add a picture in there and a title and some text above that. But now we'll go to the bio page, that small picture we added. Picture on the left, and then the text on the bio. And we'd clean it up a little bit, but it still looks pretty good. I'd probably add a title on here too. So thanks for watching. We'd love for you to subscribe. And also visit localsearchcanada.com for additional information on this video and other local search topics. And thanks for watching, and check the description for some more information.